10 mad scientists you've probably never heard of. Beyond the captivating tales of Frankenstein lies a realm of scientific fervor that few dare to enter. Mary Shelley merely hinted at it, introducing us to a world where boundaries are pushed beyond comprehension. In the shadows of innovation, there have been real-life figures who, in their quest for discovery, defied both law and morality. Sure, you've heard of the eccentricities of Nikola Tesla, but what about the others, the unsung pioneers who teetered on the brink of genius and madness? Dive with us into the enigmatic depths and uncover 10 mad scientists that history tried to keep hidden. What truths have they uncovered? And at what cost? Number 1. Robert Cornish. Dr. Robert Cornish, an exceptional mind who graduated from Berkeley at a mere age of 18 and earned his doctorate by 22, had a dark fascination that dominated his career, reanimation. By leveraging his esteemed position at Berkeley during the 1930s, he developed an innovative cell-like apparatus, aiming to revive the dead by restarting their blood circulation, augmented with a potent mix of anticoagulants. This wasn't mere theory. Cornish astonishingly brought two dogs back to life, an achievement that caught Hollywood's attention, leading to a 1935 film in which he even made a cameo. But his most audacious goal was yet to come: reanimating a human being. The significant barrier? Finding a willing test subject. After years of searching, in 1948, a condemned child murderer named Thomas McMonagall gave his consent to be the subject of Cornish's experiment after his execution. San Quentin Prison surprisingly agreed to this. Yet, Cornish faced an insurmountable procedural hurdle. Despite McMonagall's agreement, prison regulations required the body to remain in custody for hours post-execution, denying Cornish the immediacy he needed for his experiment. Consequently, his dream of reviving a human remained unrealized. Number 2. Alexander Bogdanov. Alexander Bogdanov, a revolutionary Bolshevik leader and renowned science fiction writer, became deeply engrossed in the pursuit of eternal youth through blood research. Once a political rival of Lenin, he gradually withdrew from politics and established the Institute of Blood Transfusion in 1926. Convinced that blood transfusions could offer rejuvenation, perhaps even immortality, he subjected himself to numerous transfusions, reporting remarkable personal improvements like halted baldness and enhanced eyesight. However, his quest was ironically cut short in 1928 when a transfusion using the blood of a malaria patient led to his untimely death. Number 3. Giles Brinley. Giles Brinley, a distinguished figure in urological research, was instrumental in developing a pioneering pharmaceutical treatment for erectile dysfunction. His revolutionary work was showcased at the Urodynamics Society meeting in Las Vegas in 1983. To substantiate his findings about the effectiveness of papaverine injections, Brinley displayed slides of his own post-treatment erect penis. However, recognizing the skepticism that could arise from mere visuals, Brinley took an unprecedented step. Midway through his talk, he confidently lowered his trousers, revealing to the attendees his treated erection, demonstrating the real-world impact of his research. But Brinley's determination to prove his point didn't stop there. He walked towards the front row, offering those present a first-hand examination, emphasizing that his erection was purely the result of the injection and not due to any external stimulus. Number 4. Paracelsus. Paracelsus, a 16th-century Swiss-German scientist, revolutionized medicine, biology, and chemistry. Often recognized as the founder of toxicology, he argued that small doses of toxic substances could have beneficial effects, summarized by his principle: only the dose determines if something is a poison. This perspective often put him at odds with contemporary beliefs. Alongside his scientific pursuits, Paracelsus explored alchemy and the occult. In his 1537 treatise, De Rerum Naturae, he detailed intriguing alchemical processes, notably a recipe for a homunculus. This involved allowing sperm to ferment in horse manure, evolving it into a minuscule human form, and sustaining it with human blood for 40 weeks. Number 5. Wendell Johnson. In 1939, Wendell Johnson, a psychologist at the University of Iowa, conducted what's infamously known as the Monster Study. Based on his belief that stuttering was learned, he and graduate student Mary Tudor experimented on 22 orphans. They were divided into two groups, one received encouraging feedback, while the other faced negative comments about their speech. This negative reinforcement caused some initially fluent speakers to develop a stutter. The experiment was kept under wraps until 2001, when it became public knowledge, leading to six former participants suing the university and receiving almost $1 million in damages. Number 6. Robert Knox. During the 19th century, Robert Knox stood out as a prominent figure in England's medical community, especially in the realm of comparative anatomy. He was renowned for teaching large classes at Britain's foremost anatomical institution, sometimes reaching up to 500 students per session. As the demand for cadavers grew and supply dwindled, Knox found himself in a compromising situation. He started acquiring bodies from Burke and Hare, two individuals who resorted to murder to ensure a steady supply. Over the course of 1828, they killed 16 people, a grim episode that became a dark mark in British history. All these bodies were handed over to Knox. Even though he was officially absolved from any wrongdoing, skeptics argued that a physician of his stature should have recognized the signs of unnatural death. Many believed he consciously overlooked the origins of the corpses. This entire ordeal, however, had a silver lining. The public uproar surrounding the murders heavily influenced the introduction of the Anatomy Act in 1832. Number 7. Andrew Eure. In the late 18th century, scientists were captivated by galvanization. Luigi Galvani demonstrated that electrical charges could animate dead animal muscles, most notably making frog legs twitch. This intrigue soon shifted to humans. Giovanni Aldini, Galvani's nephew, gained attention for electrifying a hanged man's body, George Foster. Yet, it was Scottish Dr. Andrew Eure who escalated the experiments. He believed galvanization might reanimate the dead. Using the corpse of executed Matthew Clydesdale, Eure inserted rods to induce violent convulsions. Shocking specific nerves, he manipulated the dead man's facial expressions, causing witnesses to flee or faint. Eure's revival attempt failed, believing the absence of blood in the body hindered the heart's revival. Number 8. Carney Landis. In 1924, Carney Landis, a psychology student at the University of Minnesota, embarked on an unconventional study. He was driven by the belief that all humans express emotions with identical facial expressions. To validate this theory, he marked lines on the faces of volunteers to trace muscle movements, then exposed them to a variety of emotional stimuli. His methods were extreme. Participants were asked to smell pungent ammonia, view provocative images, touch slippery frogs, and in a shocking climax, decapitate a live rat. While two-thirds of participants went through with the decapitation, Landis himself stepped in for those who couldn't. Worryingly, one of the participants was a 13-year-old boy. Though Landis's initial hypothesis was disproven, his approach had parallels with the renowned Milgram obedience experiment that would come decades later. Landis might not have realized it, but his research had the potential to delve deeper into the realm of human compliance and obedience. Number 9. Lytle Adams. During World War II, the US contemplated an unusual warfare tactic called Project X-Ray. This strategy involved using bats as living bomb carriers. The detailed plan was to attach napalm to hibernating bats, place them in bombshells, and release them over Japanese cities. Upon release, the bats, now awake, would disperse, taking the incendiaries with them. The idea was birthed by Dr. Lytle Adams, a dentist from Pennsylvania. He was inspired to leverage bats as weapons after witnessing a massive exodus of these creatures from the Carlsbad Caverns in New Mexico. Though such a concept might generally be brushed off, Adams had an influential ally, Eleanor Roosevelt. His connection to the First Lady meant his proposal was taken seriously. It was scrutinized and even received a nod of approval from the National Research Defense Committee. A presidential memorandum affirmed Adams' sanity, stating, "This man is not a nut." Nevertheless, after some deliberations, the bat bomb concept was eventually abandoned. Number 10. Johann Conrad Dipple. Several scientists could have inspired Mary Shelley's Frankenstein, including Andrew Eure, Giovanni Aldini, and notably, Johann Conrad Dipple. Dipple had the distinction of being born at Castle Frankenstein. A 17th-century theologian and physician, Dipple often shifted his religious beliefs, leading to confrontations with angered mobs. Known for his alchemical experiments during the rise of iatrochemistry, which focused on using chemical solutions for medical treatments, he created Dipple's oil. This was a pungent mixture made from distilling animal bones, which he claimed had various medical uses. Rumors spread due to the odors from his lab, suggesting he experimented with cadavers or attempted soul transfers. This reputation makes Dipple a strong contender for a real-life Frankenstein. However, it remains uncertain if Shelley was aware of him.